So going into the next question, talking about the blue card, so what other advantages you get when you have a blue card in Germany? Like, let me go back a bit because I forgot. Like, maybe before we go to this question, you can maybe give a range of the salary that we mentioned, because we always said like you should have a certain bracket of salary. I know that you cannot disclose it, but you can maybe give a range so that people have an idea, like, okay, if my salary is in this range, then I have the blue card and apply for PR and everything. So maybe can you give a short, like a range?
Well, after completion of your bachelor's or master's degree, if you so get a job contract, unbefristet, meaning permanent, if you get a permanent job contract with a salary range of anything more than 40, 41,000 euros, you are eligible to apply for a blue card.
Okay, that is gross per annum, right?
Yes, that's the gross amount per year.
Okay, now going into this question, like what are the advantages, other advantages of getting a blue card in Germany and also maybe outside Germany, like in the Schengen region of other Schengen countries? Like, do you know like what are the advantages or benefits?
Well, you are allowed to apply for a blue card in almost all of the European countries except UK, Denmark, and I think Ireland as well. They don't allow a blue card, but you are allowed to apply for a blue card in all of the countries. You are allowed to work in almost all of the European countries. And as far as, since I'm working in Germany, I'll say about Germany, with a blue card, you basically get 4 years of residency in Germany. So after your studies, you get 4 years of residence permit to live in Germany, work in Germany. Apart from it, there are a certain advantages, certain citizenship level advantages that you get. For example, you are allowed to apply for loans, and for example, home loans or car loans, etc. And obviously, like after being with your first employer for the first year, you are also allowed to change your job or change your employer. That is also a flexibility that the blue card comes with.
So if I understand it correctly, like if you suppose you become jobless and you have a blue card, then maybe for 3 months or 6 months when you are searching for jobs, before you land into your next employer, do you think it gives you permission to live in that European country with a blue card, or you also need the European residence permit?
That is exactly the motivation behind applying a PR. That is exactly the reason why most of the people want to convert their blue cards into a PR, because that gives you more security. When you are in a blue card, you are not allowed to discontinue your, so let's say your job relationship with your employer. And if at all you are jobless, if at all you lose your job, then you get another 90 days to look for a new job, which is in certain scenarios gets really difficult. And if you don't land up with a new job, you have to leave the country. That is, as I said, that is exactly the reason why most of the people want to convert their blue cards into a PR, because once you have the PR, your job status has got nothing to do with your residency status in the country. And for example, now I have a PR, so now I can just decide to take a sabbatical for six months, or let's say 1 year, and just take a course or do anything what I want, and I would still be allowed to live in Germany because I'm a permanent resident of Germany. But that won't happen in blue card. In blue card, as I said, you are not allowed to discontinue your employment relationship with your employer.
Okay.
To be clear and concise, to put it in so short informative words, when you finish your studies, you want to stay in the country, you want to work for the country, you want to be employed. So when you are employed, when you find a contract, when you find an employer, you have to apply for a blue card, because blue card allows you to stay in the country for the next 4 years, pay the taxes, and be a resident. But there are certain disadvantages of the blue card as well. The disadvantages, that's something that I've already mentioned. Like, for example, if you lose the employer, then you get 90 days to stay in the country. And in those 90 days, in certain scenarios, becomes difficult to find a new job. And if you don't find a new job, you're out of the country. So to fix those scenarios or to have even more stability on a blue card, you apply for a PR. So now when you have a PR, you are almost 50% resident citizenship. You almost have 50% citizenship of the country. So you, in any worst case, you cannot, nobody can throw you out of the country, which is why PR is so a better situation to have than being so being on blue card.
Mm-hmm. Okay. So thank you, Ashish, for clarifying all these questions around PR, blue card, and staying in Germany. And hopefully in the future, when you get a citizenship, if you get it, if you are applying for it, then we'll have further interviews, maybe after some years. So till next vlog, see you. Bye from Netherlands.